There's one thing that I really, 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 really hate on this boat.
Welcome, I'm Danny and this is Marvin. We gave up everything 2 years ago and we are working hard to make our dream happen.
If you don't like rolling, don't buy a sailboat.
There are parts of this dream life that you do not always see. Today, we are talking about them.
It's my anti-rolling system.
Subscribe and follow our adventures in our weekly videos.
I have to say that this lifestyle is not 100% happiness all the time. For example, yesterday we didn't sleep at all because of rolling at anchor. After this almost sleepless night, we are tired but motivated to go to a small town called Saint-Louis over here on Marie-Galante.
Marie-Galante, with its white sand beaches and clear waters, it is almost entirely dedicated to the sugarcane production. If you're in search for tranquility and a change in scenery, this is the place to go. And don't forget to taste its rum.
As we're heading towards our new anchorage, we see over there the island Les Saintes and just on the other side Guadeloupe, where we came from. We have 3.5 meters of depth and our keel is at 2.10. It just seems so incredibly wonderful. I still can't believe that we're over here. And like, there's a lot of space in the anchorages. We're so used to the Velarics where you had boats all around in little small places. And here there's nobody on the beach, beautiful sand. Just so, so, so happy to be here. We had a little training session with Marvin this morning. And now I just want to jump into the water. So let's take off these and discover the beautiful water of the Caribbean. Okay, there's one thing that I really, 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 really hate on this boat, and it's these rings. This is so good for CrossFit, but it is horrible for the aesthetics of this boat. So we'll try to hide them. I always try to hide them, but they just fall down. So we put them here. Easy for me. Now it's better. Now we will eat.
Ah! Eat what?
I'm... what is haricot vert?
Green bees.
No. I don't know what I wanted to say. Oh yes, yesterday we had the most beautiful, I think it is my top 5 sunsets, maybe top 3 even, but I forgot the camera! So I filmed a little bit for you guys with my phone. It was so, so incredible. The colors were just amazing. So never leave without your camera if you have a YouTube channel. Marvin, can you cook the eggs?
Yes,
six
sir.
6 minutes, and then we'll eat. And how is?
How many minutes?
6, please. How do we say haricot vert?
I don't know. And why 6 minutes?
Because it's mole. Okay, I'm not even French. I don't know why I know these words in French. I have to see this. Okay, so œuf mole in English.
Poached egg. Poached egg.
Poached egg. Okay? And haricot vert. Oh, green beans, booby! Is it possible? French beans. String beans.
Qui avait raison? Who's the boss?
Booby. Tara, will you help me make some eggs?
Yes.
Yes.
If you don't like rolling, don't buy a sailboat. Buy a catamaran directly. Because you live at anchor. So everybody say, yes, no, it's better to have a sailboat to sail. You sail 1% of the time and you stay 99% at anchor. So, if someone advise you buy a sailboat, ask, do you live on a sailboat? Yes or not? If they don't live on a sailboat, don't believe. You need to hear this. I push with my feet.
What's your technique to turn off this noise?
Just put this between the hole and the wood. I want to sleep.
So, Bobby? Mm-hmm. Did you sleep well?
No.
We tried a lot of techniques to reduce rolling at anchor, like the secondary anchor. So, coucou! Booby, c'est moyen! Déjà, le petit ami! Mieux?
Ouais, la minute française. Bon, on va faire vite parce qu'il y en a un qui a faim et il y en a un qui s'impatiente. Une qui s'impatiente. On va essayer de mouiller tête et cul parce qu'on a roulé hier soir et on va essayer de donc mettre un mouillage à l'arrière. Tara, regarde, je mets là. Comme ça.
Génial! Non, ça sert à ça?
Non, c'est ça.
Non.
Mais si.
Mais c'est trop bien. Mais c'est pour les opinels ou c'est que celui-là?
C'est que celui-là.
Comment on parle de couteau?
C'est Marco Pinel, Made in France, inox, et spécial outdoor. Mer, montagne et tout ça. Je vais faire la technique un peu du flemmard, c'est-à-dire que je vais juste relâcher 20 mètres de chaîne devant, attendre qu'on se stabilise, attendre que le cul du bateau aille dans la direction souhaitée. Je mouille mon ancre secondaire.
Et après tu remontes la chaîne?
Et après je remonte la chaîne. Et comme ça, en remontant la chaîne, ça va crocheter l'arrière. Et après je me mets à peu près entre les deux. Je mouille, je relâche, je reprends.
Est-ce que ça m'a approuvé?
Non, il y a la théorie et la pratique.
Donc c'est quoi la technique numéro 2?
Ouais, je vais essayer de mettre le cul du bateau dans la bonne direction et de te jeter l'ancre.
Ok. Allez. Or the flop stoppers. The flop stoppers on the whisker pole. Ça marche, Bobby?
Ouais.
All the sounds that this beautiful wooden interior makes while rolling is just starting to be
comme
unbearable.
Comme une maison hantée, là.
Yes, it's like almost a haunted house. Like.
Ah.
marbre. What is this?
It's my anti-rolling system.
Number one solution to get rid of all the creaky, squeaky noises that our boat is making. When I wake up in the morning and I see knives all over the place, I know that he didn't sleep well. Since the army, he's awakened by these little irritating noises really easily, and he's searching for gaps between wooden parts or the wood and the plastic to insert the knife and prevent them from making this noise. So it's a pretty funny solution, but actually it works, and it is making our life at anchor a lot more comfortable. So thank you, Marvin. Ask us anything you'd like to know, and don't forget to check out our Patreon page and connect with us during our monthly lives. See you next week.